I find it very nice that it's a very broad study, so you can choose any subject that you want from both electrical engineering and computer science. And this gives you, well, endless opportunities within those disciplines to do whatever you want.
I did my bachelor, which was electrical engineering, and over my bachelor I discovered I had quite an interest in digital hardware and computer architecture, which can definitely be an important part of embedded systems. It's quite a broad field, hence why I say can. Because you can focus at different areas of it. I have also had an interest for a long time, since before I even started doing my bachelor, in the point where hardware and software flow into each other a bit.
An embedded system is a device which is actually not considered as a computing system. It's not visible as a computing system. It's embedded within a larger system. This means that there are quite some tight constraints for an embedded system. It's very often very limited in power consumption. It's very often small, and it should be very reliable.
For example, the ATMs or the GPS systems, smartphones or smart trackers contain embedded processors that do some processing in there.
In your car, if you sit down and don't put your seatbelt on, then it gives a beeping sound. This is actually an embedded system because there's a sensor that registers that you're on that seat and that your seatbelt is not on. And then there's an actuator that beeps. And the in-between part is the embedded system.
It contains dedicated hardware and dedicated software, which are often working together.
Because it's a very broad field, you have both electrical engineering and computer science, it's a very broad program. You can choose from a lot of different courses from those two masters.
So we have six courses mandatory within our program: embedded systems laboratory, real-time systems, embedded artificial intelligence, systems engineering, and security services for Internet of Things. And finally, we have embedded computer architectures, which is a course which is taught by Nikos Alagiotis.
My name is Nikos Alagiotis, and I'm an assistant professor in the Computer Architectures for Embedded Systems group, and I'm also the teacher of several courses in Embedded Systems. So in the course Embedded Computer Architectures 1, we are focusing on two parts, and in the first part we are focusing on microcontrollers, and we are focusing on how input and output is handled, like collecting real input through a camera, for instance, or through a sensor, and getting the data out of it. And then in the second part, we are using FPGAs for efficient processing of this data. An FPGA is a field programmable gate array, and this is basically a hardware technology that can be reprogrammed after manufacturing.
It's like a piece of hardware where you can say, I want this hardware on this now.
It is used a lot because it's very easy to make smaller chips with it and test, for instance, the efficiency, etc.
And this means that we can optimize for a specific metric of interest. For instance, in embedded systems, we frequently have very strict requirements in terms of latency, for example. And by having a totally custom architecture without the overhead of a general purpose processor, we can guarantee that the device, the FPGA architecture, will behave within these latency requirements that we set up at the beginning.
Real-time systems covers the topic of giving timing guarantees of embedded computers,
which is an important part of a lot of embedded systems, because if you have something in real life out in the world and then it gets a signal and then it needs to respond to that signal now and then it gets another signal, so it's kind of about making sure that it executes reasonably in real time and responds to appropriate impetuses.
System engineering is about the efficient design of large systems, optimizing the large system. It involves a lot of different disciplines, scientific, technological, but also managerial skills, and it involves the complete life cycle of a product, ranging from the design of the product until the retirement of the product.
I did a course called Embedded Systems Lab, as I recall. There was a big project in that, which was most of the course. I think we had one lecture in total, which was basically in the robotics lab. Then they had this robotic arm, which had one servo, so it could go like this. One servo, so it could go like this. It could basically look in all directions. So you pointed it around and looked at stuff, and you had to make some sort of image recognition functionality with it. So we made a face tracking thing, so it would always look at you. And you had to do that all the way from the ground up, so taking the information and then forwarding it up and taking back and so on.
In embedded AI, for instance, this is a new course that started this year for the first time. And what we are interested in there is to teach how we can use embedded systems for AI applications. And the problem here is that AI is typically compute and data intensive, and embedded systems are resource bound, so they don't have many resources to use for computation, for instance. So we are exploring ways and teaching ways to actually implement practical AI applications on embedded systems that are limited in terms of resources.
The security services for Internet of Things is covering Internet of Things devices and how a larger system can be made out of individual Internet of Things devices. And then we look especially at the security aspects. How can we make such a system secure?
Well, a lot of projects are kind of, you work in pairs. It's unusual to have a project group of three, and that's the biggest they've been so far in my experience. And usually it's fine. Most people doing the master program are quite interested in putting work into the project, which is nice.
Next to the core courses, we have the elective courses, and there is a lot of flexibility in choosing these elective courses. Also, we are a 4TU program, which means that you can also choose elective courses from both the TU Delft and TU Eindhoven without any administrative burden.
Well, there are a lot of courses I can follow that I find interesting.
I did the course Pervasive Computing, which is an introductory course in the Pervasive Systems group. In which you actually are free to do any project that you like within the pervasive systems domain. And we made a sensor network which can be implemented within a city that measures the air pollution data and a specifically particulate matter.
As a student, you can make a program by yourself. So you can actually look at all the courses that are available from computer science and electrical engineering, and you can compose a program as you like. So that is possible. In order to streamline this a little bit, we defined themes: computer architectures, embedded AI, cyber-physical systems, Internet of Things, dependable computing.
I did in two separate regions my electives. First of all, I did a lot in embedded computer architecture, which has to do with how computers work and how we can optimize that, especially on an embedded platform. So that's a smaller computer, well, has less power, less processing power, etc. Which proves some difficulty, which is of course a nice challenge to solve. However, this has less to do with industrial design engineering, which is why I also chose some subjects in the pervasive systems part of embedded systems. This has to do with digital skin, which is the idea that you can put sensors anywhere, for instance on a body, but also on a chair in this room, to gather data.
And I'm also taking dependable computing systems. It's about making sure that things are hardware is dependable, so making sure you catch faults after production, making sure you catch faults during use, and making sure you're protected against malicious intent. Because if it breaks or if someone hacks into it, then that's kind of a problem for basically everything.
So after the first year, you have your second year where you can do an internship. An internship is 14 weeks, but instead of the internship, you can also do elective courses.
Do you know where or what you're going to do for that?
Yes, I am going to do an internship in a research institute in France with hardware for generating magnetic fields to control bacteria that follow magnetic fields.
So in the program, we actually have an internship. It's 20 credits, which is about one third of a year. And most students actually follow that internship. However, due to my background, where I already graduated at a company for my bachelor, I followed more courses because I already had the company experiences. And this allowed me to further get more knowledge into embedded systems.
The internship is meant to gain industrial experience. Eh? So our students, they go to a company, industrial company, where they actually work on an assignment. It's a research-oriented assignment, but it's in the context of the company. So we have students that that go to, for example, ASML, Thales, Philips, these kinds of larger companies, but also smaller companies in our area are very interested in having students from the embedded systems program. After your internship, you have the final thesis project, and the final thesis project is 28 weeks.
So one of the things that I have been working on, and a few projects, graduation projects, have focused on, was the design of custom computer architectures for processing DNA data. If we think of even the recent COVID-19 pandemic, there was a lot of accumulation of data to be processed. And one of the things that happened is that many software tools were not really designed to handle that big data. So what we are trying to do here within research in our group and through master projects is to design new custom architectures that can handle bigger data more efficiently and much faster.
I already have my master thesis laid out. I will hopefully graduate within the pervasive systems group, and I will see there if we can assist visually impaired people by triggering other senses to help them visualize the world without their eyes, of course.
It's always within a group, a research group at the university. And so the supervision is also done by the research group. And it's working on a research assignment, and these assignments are either provided by the research group, but it is also possible that if there is a company with a research assignment, and that the research assignment can be done from a company as well. And so that's part. But it's always supervised by the university.
So the nice thing about supervising students in embedded systems program is that they become your colleague for a period of time. We are brainstorming together, we come up with ideas together, we are discussing ideas and try to understand which one makes sense to move forward with. Practically every time a student comes to me, I feel like I get a new colleague for the period of the duration of the project.
Students do a lot of their assignments, but also their projects within the labs.
Depending on the courses that you take, there's a lot of facilities available relevant to those fields.
And all kinds of facilities are there, so measurement equipment, they can also construct some devices. And I think for students, not only facilities for studying are great, but also on campus, we have a lot of facilities available for them in order to develop not only professionally, but also personally.
Well, when I first came here to do my bachelor's, like 4 years ago at this point, one of the things that I really liked about it was the campus, because it was like big and green and trees and stuff.
So we do have a lot of sports facilities on campus.
There's a lot of culture stuff, which is also nice. There's a lot of dance associations and theater associations and things.
The people actually at the whole University of Twente, they're very open. You can walk into the offices of your professors and call them by their first name, ask them how their weekend went before you start a conversation, which is something that I really enjoy.
What is the ratio extroverted-introverted within embedded systems?
The problem with questions like this is that I am extremely introverted, so I don't know that many people. But it's full of engineers.
Yeah, I think if you want to study embedded systems, you of course need to be very interested in electronics and programming. Preferably have a background in either one, although it isn't necessary, as you can see. I would say that most people can fit, as long as you're interested and want to learn and can have or can build up the necessary skills. I think it should be doable for a lot of people.
Well, there's, I guess, with embedded systems, if you're interested in embedded hardware or embedded programming, if you learn those things, you can always do normal hardware and normal programming. It's a lot easier to go from specific requirements to much broader requirements than from I can do everything to now I have this box.